So we have a lot going on right here. Up here in the front, you can see the little stepper motor. Up here on top is a modified Arduino Pro. This area right in here, between the motor, you can see part of this capacitor here, regulator here, rectifier here. So this section right here is the 5-volt power supply that's running the Arduino Pro off the track rail. The motor, LokSound for decoder. You can see on the back these wires here, it's tucked in right behind here is a couple of banks of caps. They're not super capacitors, but they help with the on-rail performance, especially the fact that to get all this stuff in here, I had to remove the flywheels. And then you know, the wires go off and into the shell. And I'll tell you, this was a piece of work to try to get all this stuff inside a little switcher. Almost wish I had tried a bigger project, a bigger locomotive. The motor is connected to, I have it on my decoder as output 6. So as the motor spins down, it'll come to a stop. But the key here is it's not really coming to a stop, meaning that I've stopped telling it to move. On the contrary, I've told it to move faster than it can actually go. That is so I don't burn out the Arduino by having constant current running to it. And I just turned the function 6 back on, so it'll just start right back up again.